Hello and welcome to the 11th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can easily slow down or speed up your video and keyframe sequences in After Effects. So, over the last few episodes, we have learned about animation principles and how to create simple animations. Now, one of the main factors when creating video sequences is time. We use the timeline to set our keyframes to animate and to edit our video to create a video presentation to a specific time. As you start to build in After Effects, there are going to be various occasions where you will want to customize the time it takes for an effect to happen, the speed of an animation, or even the speed of a video. Now, you may want to slow something down or speed something up. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can easily slow down or speed up your keyframe sequences and use a feature called time stretching to slow down or speed up your video. So in this video, we are going to be covering the following topics: adjusting a keyframe sequence over time and video time stretching. So let's get into it. So here I am in After Effects and I have the project open that we worked on in the previous video. Now to follow along in this video, I suggest you have the project you worked on in the previous video open. If you can open it, great. Though, if you don't have it to hand, or you're new to this course and wish to follow along, you can open this document I have prepared especially for you in the project folder that goes with this course. You can download this project folder for a small fee. The download link with instructions is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So with the project folder open, click into the S2 Essential Practice folder, into the 11th folder, Time Stretch, and let's start with the Time Stretch After Effects file. So open this up, and you will have the same document I have open here. So if we look down in the timeline panel and look at the numbers on the time ruler, we can see that the composition time space is approximately 10 seconds. So I'll make sure my time indicator is at the start of the timeline and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. And here we can see that the animation sequence spans the entire 10 seconds of the comp. Okay, so what if I want to speed up the animation sequence? Now, we could click and drag the keyframes individually to change the sequence, but that would be tedious and time-consuming. Here is a quick tip. So I'll press spacebar to stop the preview, and I'll carefully come down into the timeline panel and click before the first position keyframe and drag over the first keyframes for position, scale, and opacity. Then I will hold shift and click and drag to select all the other keyframes. When we select the keyframes, they will turn blue. So make sure you have all the keyframes selected, and with them all selected, I'm going to come to the end frame, then press and hold Alt on the keyboard, then click and drag my frames in like so. By holding Alt and dragging, we can alter the time of the entire sequence of keyframes. So instead of my sequence spanning 10 seconds, let's hold down Alt and drag the sequence to 5 seconds. So it's half the composition. So I'll make sure my time indicator is at the start of the timeline, and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. So now we can see that the animation sequence happens a lot faster. Now notice when the preview line gets to the end of the keyframes, the circle stops. Well, this is because the sequence has ended. Now, if we want to preview just the sequence between 0 and 5 seconds, here is another quick tip. So I'll press spacebar to stop the preview, and now if I click and drag my time indicator over to the last keyframe while holding shift, the time indicator will snap to the keyframe below. So on the keyboard, I will press N. Upon click, we will see the work area just below the time ruler snap to the time indicator. So now the work area is set to 5 seconds. So I'll make sure the time indicator is at the start of my timeline and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. So now I can watch the animation in a loop and it's much faster. And I'll press spacebar to stop the preview. Okay, so with the keyframes still selected, I'm going to come to the end keyframes, then press and hold Alt on the keyboard, then click and drag my keyframes out again, like so. This time, I'll drag out to around 7 seconds. So now instead of my sequence spanning 5 seconds, it now spans 7 seconds. Now if I click and drag my time indicator over to the last keyframe while holding shift, the time indicator will snap to the frames below. On the keyboard, I will press N. Upon click, we will see the work area just below the time ruler snap to the time indicator. So now the work area is set to 7 seconds. So I'll make sure the time indicator is at the start of the timeline and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. And now we can see the animation sequence happens a little slower but faster than at 10 seconds. So that's a really easy way to alter the timing of an entire set of keyframes applied to an effect. So next, I'm going to show you how you can alter time for video. So with the project folder open, click back into the S2 Essential Practice folder, into the 11th folder, Time Stretch, and open the Video Time Stretch After Effects file. And you will have the same document I have open here. So if I make sure the time indicator is set to the start of the timeline, I'll press spacebar to activate preview. So here I have a video of a little bee I took in Hyde Park in London collecting some pollen. And right now, this is playing at its original speed. And right now we can see that this clip is spanning 25 seconds on the timeline. Now, what if I want to speed this video footage up or slow it down? Well, here is how you can do this. So I'll press spacebar to stop the preview, and I'll first click on the layer to select it. Then I'll right click and come up to time, then scroll over and select time stretch. Upon click, we will activate this little option window. So here we can see the original duration, and under this there is a stretch factor which is currently set to 100%. Okay, so let's try and speed this up first. So in the stretch factor, I'm going to type in 50. So by doing that, I'm going to speed up the video clip by half, so it's going to play at twice the speed. With 50 entered, I'll click OK. Now upon click, notice the bar for the video clip has now changed. It no longer spans the entire length of the composition. This is because we just changed the time of this clip. Okay, so I'm going to drag the time indicator towards the end of the bar holding shift. When the time indicator snaps to the end of the bar, I'll press N on the keyboard to snap the work area to the end of the clip, like so. So I'll make sure the time indicator is at the start of the timeline and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. And now we can see the video is playing faster. Okay, let's try even more. So I'll press spacebar to stop the preview. Again, I'll click on the layer to select it, right click, come up to time, then scroll over and select time stretch. Again, we will activate this little option, and this time in the time stretch factor, I'll type in 25 and click OK. Notice the bar from the video clip has changed again and is now smaller than before. So again, I'm going to drag the time indicator towards the end of the bar while holding shift. When the time indicator snaps to the end of the bar, I will press N on the keyboard to snap the work area to the end of the clip. I'll make sure the time indicator is set to the start of the timeline and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. And now we can see the video plays really fast. That is a busy bee. Okay, so this time let's try slowing it down. So I'll press spacebar to stop the preview. Again, I'll click on the layer to select it, right click and come up to time, then scroll over to select time stretch. We will activate the little option here. This time in the time stretch factor, I'll type in 200. This will now double the original time, and I'll click OK. Notice the bar for the video clip has now stretched over the entire composition and now exceeds the timeline span. What I can do this time is come up to composition, down to composition settings, and in duration, I can change this from 25 seconds to 50 and click OK. So now I want to span the work area to the entire composition. A neat trick here is to come up and simply double click on the workspace area. By double clicking on this, it will quickly snap to the entire duration of the comp. So I'll make sure the time indicator is at the start of the timeline and I'll press spacebar to activate preview. And now we can see the video has slowed down. So by using time stretch, you can speed up or slow down your video easily in After Effects. Now, what if we want to apply this effect to a series of clips at once instead of just one clip? Well, in a previous video, we learned how to edit multiple video clips in After Effects in a single composition. Now, at this point, it would be helpful for you to learn about pre-composing in After Effects. Pre-composing basically allows you to take multiple layers in compositions and place them into a single composition, to allow you to control that one composition separately. Pre-composing in After Effects can make your workflow much easier and improve your organization. And it allows you to work much more effectively. In the next video, we are going to look at pre-composing in After Effects. So see you in the next video.